Hi guys, feel warmly welcome to Usitility. Do you know what? We are going to discover how to run FRAG Pro Shooter on PC. As you can see now, you're able to watch it on your screen. It takes almost no time to simply download and install FRAG Pro Shooter so that we can enjoy this game on our Windows computer with keyboard, mouse and large monitor. So it's time to have fun, let's go my friends. Before anything else my friends, the first thing to do is to open our favorite browser. We have here the one we use by default. Let's continue, going to this URL I have highlighted in green. There you are seeing it on the screen. There is no need to type the URL, simply because there's the clickable link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We ended up on this page on our own site of Usitility, where we have a nice precise explanation on the best way to download FRAG Pro Shooter on laptop or computer. We search lower tad and then click on the download game on PC button. After we click on that link, we reach the site of LDPlayer, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play FRAG Pro Shooter on the PC. As you can see from here, we get a great deal of pros of preferring using the emulator, custom controls, multiple instances, instance synchronization, macros, scripts, high FPS, etc. So we are on the way to start downloading the FRAG Pro Shooter by simply clicking on the button download FRAG Pro Shooter on PC that I have marked in green. Next step is clicking on it. Of course, the download takes no time at all. Voila! This is the download. It is a file to execute. What we have to do now is to run the executable file, okay, so we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to allow modifications to the laptop or device. We have said yes. I minimize the web browser to find the installation software much better. The installation software is pretty simple. It contains a couple of options: install and setup path. I will describe what setup path really does. We simply just click on it, and so we discover that we got here the path where the emulator will be put in. If we would like to modify this folder, we need to click on that browse button, and therefore we decide on another folder and install the emulator precisely where we want. To keep it simple, just leave it as it is. I click on back, and therefore I pick install. At this moment, before you start setting up this emulator, it is possible that it'll present us a number of application software offers to put on our computer. Since I do not wish to have any of these software programs, I simply click several times on the reject option. Great, the install commences and it is going to proceed along with the download of those megabytes that happens to be shown on our screen. As you save it on your machine, it is likely to be more or less MB. The download speed might go faster or at a lower speed, depending on your internet and according to the performance of the emulator web servers. Right away they're working superbly fast. The download is done, so at present it continues on with the installation part. The installation will require a little bit more or less time according to the strength of your personal computer. The more robust it's actually, the faster the installation time and or vice versa. If we combine the download and setup phase, it will take quite a long time, so be patient. It is by now ended on my side. At this time, the emulator has actually been started successfully. As you can see now, at the bottom of the screen, we have a progress bar which will fill up when it attains the end. The emulator is launched for the first time. Believe it or not, the emulator is already started, there for the first time. And therefore LD Store is by default started, which is actually a kind of Google Play. That isn't the optimal method to set up the game, and so I don't propose it, merely because in certain cases the LD Store installs an out-of-date version of the game. I am going to demonstrate the best way to install the game utilizing the Google Play, so I recommend you to do it this way. First of all, we will have to make is to visit desktop by simply clicking this icon that I am indicating in green. Before we continue on, as you understand, it has made a couple of icons right here on the PC desktop. The LD Player and LD Multiplayer. Note that the LD Player icon is going to be the one we're considering. Each time we need to start FRAG Pro Shooter on our laptop or computer, we double-click this software icon and launch the emulator. The LD Multiplayer app icon isn't related to multiplayer or anything at all like this. Indeed, it's an icon that we would almost certainly never ever start using. Let me make the next phase, which is actually a must, and which is to begin browsing the Google Play Store. To achieve this, we will go there to System Apps, we click on, and we'll mouse click on Play Store. As can be seen, the Google Play is presented. At this point we are required to sign in. Currently, the moment we're on this page, we must perform the next step that is definitely obligatory. Therefore, simply click on Sign In. At present it announces Checking Info. It could once in a while get stuck in Checking Info, and so it doesn't move ahead. In that case, you should attempt to connect to your account after a few hours and it may most likely be repaired. At present we shall provide our username and password. The email needs to be a Gmail email as well as its related password. As an example, you may use the very same email you're using right now in your own YouTube account. So I am going to enter my info and I will come back after I have completed it. Voila! Information typed in. Discover Google welcoming us and offering us their terms of service. We will say yes to them by just hitting, I agree. Then, it allow us to save to the Google Cloud. You can also leave it selected and it'll produce a backup of the data files on this device to Google Drive. I won't select it, you do what you want. We just click on accept. By now Google Play is presented by default and instantly. If the Google Play just isn't started immediately and you're unsure how to launch it by yourself, I explain to you how to do this. Firstly is to proceed to the emulator desktop by clicking on this software icon marked in green. Presently we navigate to the system apps folder. And we select the Play Store icon. Great, I am right here into Google Play. What we're going to accomplish will be go here to search for apps and games. And consequently we're going to locate FRAG Pro Shooter. So there we have it, we can select the first result. On this page we access to the game app. Let's click right here on the Install option that I'm presenting now in green. This action will initiate the software installation. Straight away it will download and install the video game. It can take some time or perhaps it could possibly be very quick. It again all is subject to on our connection to the web. It has actually finished setting up. It's time to go back to the emulator desktop by simply clicking on this specific option that I'm showing in green, so that you can run FRAG Pro Shooter for the very first time. I am at present on the emulator desktop, and so we are going to click that new FRAG Pro Shooter software icon that's been provided. That Android game is started for the first time on your computer. There we get it. I could click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to talk about the sound level of that emulator. It is right here. We have got the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we won't use the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of your emulator. And also to appreciate the experience to the maximum, we will turn on the large monitor, for which we have two options. This one is simply the very first one. We mouse click on this software icon that I'm designating in green. Thus the display screen is maximized, experiencing one border at the top, one at the right and one at the bottom. If ever we aspire to play the application in full screen, we hit this particular app icon. And we presently be experiencing and enjoying the game in 100% screen setting. To leave the complete screen mode, just click the F11 key. And so we would undoubtedly currently play in normal display mode. At this point, I am ready to explain you the computer keys mapping, which is really quite appealing. That means we definitely will be capable to make use of the game application far more easily. The first thing is to click this keyboard icon. It's now time to complete the recommended configurations. Let me keep the default settings, but if you plan to modify that, you may well do so without any problem. I use this moment to say that once in a while, when starting the game app a black screen shows up. If it's so and you get the black screen and this emulator is unable to initiate, I comment a plausible solution. We can hop on over to the cogwheel. Inside the emulator preferences, in the advanced selection we have now a number of resolutions. That is the resolution we've presently decided to go with as favorite choice, therefore we must choose any of these additional image resolutions, for instance this one down below. We go for it and therefore click on save. It will require us to restart this emulator and immediately after restarted, likely the emulator will commence and that black display screen will be completely removed. Obviously, the emulator is absolutely in our own language. Once in a while it happens that your emulator is started in the incorrect language, such as, in Chinese language. And so to set it up in the proper language we go there to the cogwheel. So right here throughout many other settings, we mouse click on that language drop down. We may opt for the language we need. Spanish, Mandarin, and so on. After the language is determined, we are going to save, the emulator would reboot, and the video game, the next time we start it, would also be in the picked language. Right now, you will find another thing that we have to take into account, and it's that we will receive a message from Gmail telling you that a brand new electronic device has been linked to our own Google account. It will definitely check with us if we are the individuals who have connected that device. Yes, we ought not worry, since the emulator is acting as an Android smartphone or tablet. And in order to identify which smartphone or tablet is currently being emulated, we come right here, to the cogwheel and we click on it. Be sure you browse here to the model selection. And now we see that the emulator is behaving like a Samsung cellular phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it, guys, so much for our video user demo. I hope you enjoyed it, particularly that you thought it was helpful. If that is so, offer it a nice thumb up, subscribe to my channel, and I will be happy to answer your feedback, questions or suggestions, leave them in the comment field below. You may also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams on occasion, you get it listed below in the video description and in the first pinned comment. Check out any of those online videos that happens to be showing up on the computer screen and see you in the future online videos. Bye.